Hello, I'm Ken with Orion Telescopes Binoculars, and this is the SkyLine 6-inch Dobsonian telescope. As you can see, it's a reflector telescope, a 6-inch, and what makes it Dobsonian is the base dial. It just swivels left and right, up and down on these bearings. Dobsonians are probably the easiest type of scope to use for just looking at the sky. If you just want to plop a scope down outside, take a look at the moon, the planets, and with 6-inch aperture, you can get into some deep sky objects as well. Well, you can't beat a Dob. It's just the easiest thing to do to take this outside and use it. So my favorite type of telescope for viewing. The SkyLine 6 comes with a bunch of really nice features, so let's get into them and I'll show you what they include. One of my favorite features of the SkyLine 6 is the focuser. A lot of 6-inch Dobsonians have a basic, simple 1¼-inch focuser. Well, this one is really nicely machined. It's CNC machined. It's a Crafer design, not a rack and pinion, so you get a nice smooth motion with no backlash. And it attaches with a compression lock, so your eyepiece sits in and grabs the compression lock. And then you've got a lock here and an adjustment to get the right tension. So a really nice 1¼-inch focuser included with the scope. The SkyLine comes with two eyepieces, a 25mm, which I've got installed here, and a 9mm down on the accessory tray. There's a finder scope on the side, a 6x30 finder, so it amplifies the view. The 30mm lens sucks in more light than your eyes do, so you can actually see some of the details and more stars when you're looking through it. If you look down on the side here, we've got the spring tension system, so it holds the optical tube to the mount and gives you that perfect amount of tension. It's nice and smooth going up and down, and then when you let go, it stays put. And then left and right, it uses a low friction bearing on the bottom. So again, very smooth motions. You can go in a diagonal, and when you let go, it stays exactly where you have it, nice and balanced. And then on the side, I think I mentioned briefly before the 9mm, well, it's installed in a accessory tray, so you can slip in your accessories, Bartle lens, extra eyepieces, you can put them in there and store them for later use. And then let me just talk about what you can see with a 6-inch Dobsonian telescope. This is a great beginning telescope. I mean, when you think of a beginning telescope, a lot of times you see the little 60 or 70mm refractors. Well, 6-inch sucks in so much more light, and it's on such a more stable mount that you're going to get so much more use out of this thing. It's going to last a lifetime rather than something that you buy and then realize, oh, you know what, I should have gotten something bigger. They call that aperture fever, right? Or something that's just not going to suit your needs. So a 6-inch is sort of a lifetime telescope. Not only moon and planets, you can see the rings of Saturn, a couple of cloud belts on Jupiter, the moons around Jupiter. Our moon will look like you're in orbit around it. But 6-inch aperture sucks in enough light to really get into the deep sky objects as well. So assuming you can get away from some of the city lights, or maybe get a light pollution filter or a nebula filter to increase the contrast, you can see the Orion Nebula, all sorts of different star clusters, the Andromeda Galaxy. There's planetary nebula like the ring or the dumbbell that will come into view with a 6-inch aperture. So all in all, a very good telescope for a multitude of different objects in the night sky. All right, well, there you have it. This is the SkyLine 6-inch Dobsonian telescope. Thank you very much. Clear skies.